Hello students, welcome to all. Look at this picture. This picture is about Paithani, Maharashtra's Mahavastra. Clothes or sari weaved by weavers. Weavers is a person who weaves clothes by hand. So today we are going to learn a poem, Indian Weavers by Sarojini Naidu. Let us see about poetess Sarojini Naidu. 1879 to 1949. She was a political activist, feminist, and the first Indian woman who became the president of the Indian National Congress. She was an important figure in India's struggle for independence. Sarojini Naidu's work as a poet earned her the sobriquet of Nightingale of India. Later, she became the governor of the United Provinces in 1947. Becoming the first woman to hold the office of the governor in independent India. Let us see the poem. Indian Weavers. Weavers weaving at break of day. Why do you weave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of a halcyon wild, we weave the robes of a newborn child. Weavers weaving at the fall of night. Why do you weave a garment so bright? Like plumes of a peacock, purple and green, we weave the marriage veils of a queen. Weavers, weaving solemn and still, what do you weave in the moonlight chill? White as a feather and white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. Let us see the paraphrase of a poem. First stanza indicates the beginning of life as a newborn baby. Poetess asked to the weavers that why they are weaving clothes in the morning, which is very beautiful and charming. The clothes are blue and like the wing of a halcyon. Halcyon stands for kingfisher as a bird. The wings of a kingfisher are bright blue in color. Here, blue color indicates the royalty and tenderness of mind, which is precious and beautiful. Weavers reply that they are weaving the clothes for the newborn baby who had just came in this world. This stanza indicates the charming life of a human with a full of happiness, tenderness, hope, freshness, beauty. Like a newly born child, there is no place for ill feeling and sorrow. Second stanza, weavers weaving at fall of night. Why do you weave a garment so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green, we weave the marriage veils of a queen. Second stanza indicates the adulthood of a human life. It was the evening time, everywhere darkness in path, and poetess meets with weavers and asks that why they are weaving so bright garment like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green in color. Poetess observe that garments are very bright and it have a purple and green color like a feather of a peacock. The weavers reply that they weave the marriage veils of a queen. It is an adult stage of a human in which got married. In this stage, human are active and tries to lead a prosperous life. In this stage, human generally face ups and downs of life to make his life prosperous. Third stanza. Weavers weaving solemn and still. What do you weave in the moonlight chill? White as a feather and white as a cloud, we weave a dead man's funeral shroud. The third stanza indicates the end of life with struggle in grief. In this final stanza, poetess observe that weavers are very calm and still under the moonlight. They are quiet and silent. They are weaving some white garment. Garment is as white as the cloud. Cloud is a colorless, indicating emotionless and lifelessness of life. In this way, according to the poetess, life begins with joy and charm. At middle stage, it is full of struggle and prosperity, and human life ends with sorrow and grief. The colors also tells the story of the three stages of man's life. Indian Weavers is a short poem consisting of three stanzas having a four lines each. The poetess talks about three types of dresses that the Indian weavers weave at three particular times of the day. Metaphorically, each time and the dress weaved in that time symbolizes a particular stage of life. We find that the poem has been structured in a question-answer pattern. Thank you.